and Ohio.
Matchup between the Akron Zips and your Miami Redhawks. At this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your hats as we honor our country with the playing of our national anthem. Now let's meet tonight's starting lineups, beginning with the visiting Zips of Akron. Wearing number one, Lauren Jackson. Number four, Tyler Cheese. Wearing number 10, Dan Riak. Number 11, Channel Banks. And wearing number 20, Xeyrius Williams. The assistants are Rob Bolford, Robbie Friedkin, and Justin Ford. The head coach of Akron is John Brooks.
Can I see that again?
Which one? Theirs?
Theirs. Tuesday night action in Oxford, Ohio. Welcome in, everybody, from Millett Hall in Oxford. It is the Akron Zips on the road to take on the Miami Redhawks. I'm Steve Baker, and alongside is Randy Hollowell. We have Bennett Wise on the sideline tonight. The Akron Zips come in at 4-1, leading the East Division of the Mid-American Conference, suffering their first loss in their last outing, though, Randy.
Yeah, 4-1, as you mentioned, and this team is loaded, especially offensively. Four of their five starters average double figures, and of those four wins in the MAC, all of them by double digits.
And they, as you said, a very veteran team, and their point guard is a good one. Lauren Christian Jackson gets it done for them.
Yeah, he's leading the team in scoring, averaging 17.5 per game, coming off a career high of 33 in that loss to Toledo on Saturday. He's originally started his career at Long Beach State, transferred in, and he is a scorer. There's no question about it. This team shoots a lot of threes, and he really is up front as far as that's concerned.
Miami comes in at 1-4 in conference play, but another junior, Nike Sabandi, is leading the way for Jack Owens.
Yeah, 14.5 points per game. He can do it inside. He can do it outside. He loves to get out on transition with the fast break. Coming off a double-double in that loss against Ball State on Saturday with 16 points, 10 rebounds. And he is really a do-it-all guard for Owens.
He'll have to do it all tonight. Let's check in and get the coach's perspective. Down on the sidelines is Bennett Wise.
Well, John Gross said the Zips need to make an impact on Nike Sabandi and Delonte Brown. He said that Toledo's Marion Jackson absolutely exploited them with her 36 points in handing Akron their first loss in conference play of this season. He said they need to get back to their fundamentals of speed and the pick and roll. Jeff Rutter for Miami told me that they need to stay compact on defense, get over ball screens as opposed to going under, and they have to play as a unit, and help defense needs to be there all around.
Thank you very much, Bennett Wise. That's what the coaches have to say. What's Randy Hollowell have to say as far as the keys to the game?
Yeah, for the Zips, go deep. As we said, they shoot the three, and they shoot it a lot. They are first in the MAC, not only in field goal percentage, but also made free three-pointers as well. Also a balanced attack. As we mentioned, four of their five starters are averaging double digits. And what's interesting about this team is they've had 15 games with where players had at least 20 points. For Miami, fast start. Their last three games, they've had double-digit leads in the first half. They need to then hold it after halftime and feed the freshman. Day-Day Grant's been exceptional this year. 10 times he's been in double figures.
Let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups. First for the Akron Zips. And for their head coach, John Gross, it looks like this. Dang Reak, the senior. He's a graduate student, actually. Xeyrius Williams is another senior, Tyler Cheese, and of course Lauren Christian Jackson, along with Chandler Banks. For Jack Owens and his Miami Redhawks, same lineup they've seen over the last several games. Bam Bowman, the big man in the middle. Nike Sabandi, the shooting guard, and running that point, the freshman Day-Day Grant. The officials for tonight's contest, Frank Spencer, Jabir Walker, and Brooks Wells, were set for action, and the tap controlled by the Miami Redhawks.
Yeah, Miami now will start on offense. We'll see what they do here to go against this long and athletic inside of Akron.
Man-to-man defense. Sabandi drives, and no basket. A foul before the shot, and they wave it off, and the foul will be on Chandler Banks. The senior from Las Vegas, Nevada, gets his first and the team's first. Miami will inbound the ball, and that was a blow-by and a half there by Sabandi.
I was going to say, he didn't waste any time as you look at John Gross there. Now in his third year back in the MAC, now with Akron, he had coached at Ohio University previously.
This is Majay White on the right side with it, looking low, nothing there, back to Sabandi. Sabandi again will drive, now feed out to Delonte Brown. Dang Reak comes and gets him. Now a little scoop by Delonte Brown is no good, and the rebound is out to Xeyrius Williams, and ahead it goes now. Jackson will come and get the basketball.
Yeah, Miami got a decent shot that time from Brown, just was not able to hit it.
Williams straight away look at a three, and this one is off the mark. Zips lead the MAC in seasonal three-point shooting. Miami here in the conference schedule as the top three-point shooting team. Right side, that's the freshman, Day-Day Grant, with the first two.
Yeah, he's off to a hot start. We mentioned 10 times this year he's been in double digits, including his last six games.
Freshman out of Lorain, Ohio, gives Miami the early lead. Just over a minute gone by. Christian Jackson turns, fires, and hits the triple. Yeah, catch and shoot.
That's one guy you do not want to leave open outside. They'll let Williams shoot the three, but not Jackson. They have to get somebody in his grill at all times.
39% from outside the arc is Lauren Christian Jackson. 1 point Akron lead as Miami with the basketball. And a steal by the point guard. He'll fire from the right side and hit. Back-to-back triples by Lauren Christian Jackson. And it's a 4 point Akron advantage.
Yeah, that's part of their regular offense on the fast break. If Jackson gets the ball like there, he's going to jack it. We talked about it. They lead the MAC not only in percentage, but made 3-pointers.
This is Bam Bowman, the big man for Miami. He can shoot it from out there, but Reak is on him. Day-Day Grant with the top of the key three. And it's right now Christian Jackson and Day-Day Grant putting on the show.
Yeah, battle of point guards at this point between the freshman and the junior.
This is Tyler Cheese with the basketball, gives it to Williams. He'll put it on the floor. Out to Chandler Banks around the screen. He's going to drive to the right of the key. Xeyrius Williams again for three. Bank is open for Williams, and that's three trays in the ball game for the Akron Zips, and they lead at 9-5.
Yeah, normally Miami is going to let him shoot it. He doesn't shoot very good percentage-wise, Williams does. He's more of an inside player, but sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
This is Day-Day Grant working against Christian Jackson, getting to the rack, and a blocking foul will be called. Will they count the basket? That foul will be on Tyler Cheese.
And there's a discussion, I think, on whether he was in the restricted zone, if that's what the call was, or if there was contact outside of it. And they're going to say the basket's good.
Jack Owens, and the basket will count. The foul is on Tyler Cheese, his first, team second. Day-Day Grant with all seven of Miami's points. He can make it eight from the free throw line. A look at it there. And, yeah, he was well outside the restricted zone. Looked like he was pretty well set as well.
Yeah, so they get him for the block. And that's the third time now Miami has driven it inside. We saw it once from Grant, once from Nike Sabandian, once from Brown.
So Grant at the free throw line, only a 67% free throw shooter as the freshman, and he's too strong with that one, but he got his own rebound. He's going to hang, fire, and miss that one. Rebound tapped out, and getting the rebound is Channel Banks, and ahead he'll bring the basketball. Dribbles to the left side, gives it out there to Cheese. Just about 3 minutes gone by here in the half as Cheese will drive all the way to the basket, and that'll be an offensive foul on Dang Reak away from the ball. He kept screening Delonte Brown as he got across the top of the key. Reak gets his first, and that's the third team foul against the Zips.
Yeah, Reak is the only one of those starters that doesn't average double digits, but he's a space eater. He'll grab you some rebounds, and he will collect some garbage when needed.
This is Delonte Brown, had the ball knocked away out of bounds. It is off of Williams. It'll stay with Miami.
Yeah, that time again, quick hands. We've seen it several times here. Akron willing to get into the passing lanes and if you have that ball loose, they will take a chance at it.
Whistle and a foul on Jackson grabbing the jersey of Day-Day Grant. So Lauren Christian Jackson gets a foul, his first and the team's fourth.
Yeah, already four fouls, as you mentioned, against Akron. Nothing yet against the Redhawks.
Day-Day Grant in the backcourt will chase down the basketball. 19 to shoot for Miami. Goes to the right side. Bam Bowman fakes the three. Drives, feeds to the right side. Myjay White will drive. High off the glass, no good. Rebound off the hand of Bam Bowman as he went up to try and rebound. That was a wild shot by Myjay White. Went at the rack, but put it up off the glass way too hard. As into the game for the Zips will come Cameron Reese, 6'7 junior out of Oakland, California. And Reak will head to the sideline.
I think on that last shot by White, he thought he would either get contact or was trying to get it over some arms, and was a little bit hard with that shot.
Coming up on 16 and a half minutes to play in the half is Christian Jackson on the left side, drives, feeds out top, Xeyrius Williams, Banks on the right side, hands it back off out front. Coming up on 10 to shoot, they go down low to Reese on the right side, he'll put it on the floor, whistle and a foul arm bar will be called there against Bam Bowman. That'll be his first and the team's first. And that foul comes with only 7 seconds to shoot. They'll put 20 back on the shot clock here.
Yeah, that time, just again, he got past the hip of Bowman, and all he could do was kind of push him a little bit.
Xeyrius Williams misses the three. The rebound tapped around and into the hands of Miami's Day-Day Grant, who gives to Sabandi. Side, Day-Day Grant walks with a basketball. You'll see it every time. A shuffle of the puppies, and the turnover gives it back now to Akron. And for Miami, that is their second turnover of the contest. As into the game is Greg Trimble. He is a freshman out of Cincinnati. And he will run the point as Lauren Christian Jackson gets a breather on the bench.
Yeah, Trimble, 6'1", out of Winton Woods. Also went to prep school for a year. And there's a push-off by, we've seen Day-Day Grant take several of those in the last few games. Doing a good job to get position in front.
Offensive foul called on Greg Trimble, his first, team's fifth. Timeout, the under-16 timeout has the Akron Zips out in front of the Miami Redhawks by two here in Millett. Men's College Basketball is brought to you on ESPN by Skyline Chili. Feeling good? It's Skyline time. Look at the conference standings going into this night, this evening's game. You see Akron and Bowling Green tied atop the East Division, while Ball State is alone at 4-1. But a whole bunch of teams right behind, with Miami and Eastern Michigan bringing up the rear. Red Hawks looking for that second win. Nearly got it over the West-leading Ball State Cardinals last Saturday.
Yeah, played a very tough game. Again, double-digit lead in the first half. They gave it up by halftime, but played with them in the second half. And you know, Miami's got to feel good about themselves. Of their last three games, they've lost two of them, but both of those, like even Buffalo, they had big leads, and they just need to find a way to hold it in the second half.
They did that a week ago here against Kent State. They had the big lead, but found a way to win in that game. Savandy out front, works against Tribble. Gives it out to Myjay White and Day-Day Grant, who has all of Miami's points. They go down low. Delonte Brown hits it off the bottom of the backboard, and ahead comes Tribble with the basketball. In a while since either of these teams has scored, Tribble gets to the block and then gets cut off. Lobs it out top to Cheese. Left side, Williams. He'll tee up a three and hit the three. Xeyrius Williams with a couple of trays, and it's a five-point advantage for the Akron Zips.
Yeah, that looks to be their game plan right now, is to post him up outside the three-point line and let him shoot, and Miami's sloughing off of it.
Sabandi, after that initial drive, has been quiet, but he'll fire the three there, and Williams clears the rebound off the miss. Ahead to Cheese. Cheese taking it right down the lane off the glass and score and one. Nobody stopped the basketball, and Tyler Cheese, the senior from Albany, Georgia.
Yeah, a technical has been called against Akron, I believe.
Delonte Brown gets the personal foul, team second. And now the officials talking about the technical here.
I'm not sure if it was against Jackson.
I think it was against. It was Tribble. Yeah, Tribble gets a technical. That'll be his first in the team. His first technical and his second personal. And so we'll go down and Day-Day Grant will shoot the technical free throw. And it's good. He'll get another. So Tribble, as Brooks Wells is still talking now with John Gross, as Day-Day makes them both, and he's got nine. Puts that lead back down to five, and now we'll go to the other end and shoot the and one here.
Yeah, so Tribble now with two personal fouls as well.
Elijah McNamara into the game for Miami. The 6'9 sophomore out of Pickerington, Ohio, will replace Bam Bowman. So Cheese, 80% free throw shooter. The lefty fires it up and gets it. He's got three in a row, and the lead is six for the Akron Zips. Christian Jackson back into the ball game as Tribble picked up that second foul. This is Grant out front, hassled by Cameron Reese in a backdoor cut. Couldn't handle the basketball. Delonte Brown had it knocked away by Lauren Christian Jackson, and it'll stay with Miami, 17 to shoot.
It's actually Williams that comes across, and right there he tips it just away from Brown. Good job getting the long arms. And, you know, that's looked like he was wide open, and then at the last second, Williams just flicked his hand out there.
Williams will go out as Ali. Ali is into the game. Also, Channel Banks returns to the lineup for the Zips. 17 to shoot here for Miami. Out front, Delonte Brown finds Sabandi top of the key.
We got a mismatch down low if they can find Brown.
Offensive foul called on Elijah McNamara as he curled that left arm around. McNamara gets his first, team's third, and the ball goes back to Akron.
Yeah, they had Brown down low on Jackson, and they just couldn't get him the basketball before the foul was called.
Tyler Cheese, senior from Albany, Georgia, brings the ball up the floor for Akron. It's a screen set out front by Ali. And then by Reese. Curls down the lane, hangs off the glass, a little spin, no good, and rebound over the back. Cameron Reese is guilty of the foul. The junior from Oakland, California, gets his first, and that's the sixth team foul.
There you saw twice Myjay White going, as you see the
seventh,
drive.
Excuse me.
Sorry, yeah, the drive and then the foul by Reese from behind, but twice Myjay White fighting over that screen, and that's what Bennett Wise talked about in our pregame, that the coaching staff wanted them to do defensively. Myjay White, a good example of that there.
We'll walk to the other end, and Delonte Brown will be shooting the one-and-one. Again, that technical on Greg Tribble was a personal foul as well, so thus the team's seventh. Free throw by Brown is up and good. His first point, and anybody other than Day-Day Grant's first point wearing a white uniform here tonight. We are almost 6 minutes into this game.
Yeah, interesting that, and Grant's done it in various ways, but finally Miami gets some free throws from Brown. Hopefully that opens it up for the rest of the team as well.
Cuts the lead down to four. Coming up on 14 minutes to play here in the half as Jackson brings the ball across the timeline, hassled by Grant, bounces it to the right side. Cheese, they look to get the pick and roll. They get it down to Reese, double team down there. He'll dribble out of it, looks for help now, and gives it out to Banks with 10 to shoot. Lobbing it back down low to Reese. He's going to go to work on McNamara. Lowers that shoulder. Turns toward the basket. Now bounces it to the left side. Jackson drives. Teardrop is up. And he gets the shooter's roll.
Good defense that time by Miami for almost the entire shot clock. But then at the very end, you see what Jackson can do as he generates some offense on his own.
Just out there and pops the floater. And Delonte Brown launches the three. It doesn't go. And the rebound tapped to Banks. Akron with the lead by six. They've led by as many as seven. Cheese in the left corner. He drives to the left of the key. He'll miss the shot, and McNamara skies for the rebound for Miami.
Good block out that time by McNamara, using his long arms to get to the board.
Sabandi straight away looking at a three is off the mark. And Banks with a nice box out gets it ahead to Jackson for the Zips. 13 minutes of play in the half. Banks straightaway steps into it and knocks down another triple. Another three for the Zips and a 9-point advantage for the Zips as a 30-second timeout taken here by Jack Owens. The use it or lose it, not a bad time to use it as the Zips in their three parade continues, Randy.
Yeah, the momentum all the way with the men in blue right now, and you can see they're lighting it up now, starting to from the outside, and that's what they do best. They shoot threes, as we mentioned, as good as anybody in the country, and they started out red hot here in the first half.
Tough to keep up with them when they're making it a 5-of-7 clip right now from outside the arc, and their opponents only shoot 26% from outside the arc, and you see it here. Xeyrius Williams and Lauren Christian Jackson hit four in the contest, and then Channel Banks late here has added another one, as you see Lauren Christian Jackson doing the job both inside and out.
Yeah, and you talked about those three guys, Lauren Christian Jackson, Tyler Cheese, or Channel Banks, and Xeyrius Williams. Those are the three top three-point shooters, and they've been getting them open shots all half.
Trapping zone right now by the Zips as into the game is Makai Leary. He has the ball out front. Isaiah Coleman lands also in for Miami as Jack Owens looking for a little offense other than Day-Day Grant. He's going to shake and bake, fire from 19. That's well off the mark. Rebound tapped through the hands of Delonte Brown and picked up by Christian Jackson ahead to Cheese. He's going to lose the ball off his foot out of bounds. And that's a good call. Cheese doesn't believe it, but it went off those brightly colored yellow shoes that he wears and went out of bounds. As into the game for the Zips will come Michael Dawson. 6'5", freshman out of Huntington, West Virginia.
Yeah, that time Cheese just a little bit out of a control as he tried to cut back to his left in between two Red Hawks and couldn't keep control of the dribble.
Larry gives it to Day-Day Grant off the right side, 18 to shoot. McNamara out front. Tight defense by the Zips as Delonte Brown got by his man. Feeds McNamara, fakes, fires, and misses it. Went too hard with it. And Xeyrius Williams with the rebound as he came in during that last timeout. 12 minutes to play here in the half, and Jackson stepped out of bounds. He was on the sideline as he slipped on the near sideline, and we have a timeout, 11:56 to play here in the first half, and the Akron Zips enjoy their largest lead at 9 thanks to the triple from Channel Banks. Stepped into it, got his first three, and the Zips with a big lead.
Or D. Isaiah Coleman Lance.
But Kent stay first. Kent up first. Yeah, what did I say? Kent State? My bad. Yeah, Akron first. Yikes. I don't think having him on a camera is a good thing.
He doesn't either.
Whiner.
Bake, he just said to me that I should go to Hayden next time so he doesn't have to stand.
Whiner.
Zips with a 9-point advantage about midway through this first half. Let's check in on the sidelines with Bennett Wise.
Well, John Gross reiterated that they need to have all five guys going towards the glass. Got to do a better job collecting rebounds overall. In addition, they said let's have Miami keep shooting those three-pointers. They've had the 28th best defense from outside at holding opponents to just 28% from three. For Miami, Jack Owens said, don't be casual. Anticipate whoever you're covering is going to shoot the ball off the pick and roll.
Miami with the basketball, trailing by 9, equals the Zips' largest lead. And again, that 1-3-1 trapping zone by the Zips, half-court zone. And Williams, the long body out front, tough to get that ball around.
Yeah, again, against the trap and against the zone, you want to try to find the middle, an opening in the middle of the court. Miami now finally gets it to the middle, and almost a travel that time by Larry.
Bang React back into the game. And Larry out front with 14 to shoot, feeding to the corner to Coleman Lands. He'll get it back to Larry. 9 to shoot. Larry working against Lauren Christian Jackson. Gives to Day-Day Grant. And a 3 went down and came back out. And the rebound is out of bounds off of Delonte Brown. It'll go to the Akron Zips.
Yeah, he just couldn't corral it. But you see, that's what happens sometimes against the zone. It's tough to rebound. Miami got inside position. Brown just couldn't hold on to the basketball.
Milos Jovic is into the game for the Redhawks. The redshirt junior from Laskovic, Serbia, replaces Delonte Brown. Redhawks have gotten 3 field goals here in almost 9 minutes of basketball. The Zips scoring about 76 points a game, but only giving up 63 as Xeyrius Williams misfires, but Reac has the rebound. Finds Channel Banks on the right side. He'll tee up a 3, and there it is. Channel Banks has a couple of triples, and the lead is now up to 12.
Yeah, that's what they do. They'll work it around, find the open shot. And if you allow them to get the long rebounds, they're just going to continue to fire from outside.
Man-to-man defense as Jovic gets to the paint and has the shot blocked and taken away. And Jovic diving for the basketball, getting it back, will have a jump ball. And the alternating possession will belong to the Akron Zips as Dawson is down there to tie up Jovic. Nike Sabandi and Bam Bowman ready to check back in as you see it here.
Yeah, good hustle by Jovic there. You see him go in between two Zips to get a hand on the ball and then force the jump ball after getting his initial shot blocked.
So Day-Day Grant heads to the sideline, as does Eli McNamara for Miami, with Sabandi and Bowman back into the game. Lauren Christian Jackson with the basketball. Reac sets the screen for him as he gets across the timeline. Out front, Williams, he's going to put it on the floor this time. Get to the basket, try and take advantage of the size advantage. Doesn't get the shot to go, but the rebound is off the hands of Bam Bowman. It stays with the Zips.
Yeah, Miami just not grabbing the basketball with some authority here on rebounding. We've seen it on both ends. Nice drive that time by Williams to get around Jovic. Just a little bit short with the layup, but as you mentioned, Bowman not grasping the basketball and lets it go out of bounds.
Tyler Cheese back into the game, replacing Dawson. It'll be Cheese to inbound it to Williams in the corner. Turns, fires, scores the 3. Splash another one for Xeyrius Williams. He has 9, and the lead is up to 15.
Yeah, came into the game 3rd on the team and made 3-pointers, and he's continuing to fire. He's not bashful with shooting the 3, the transfer out of Dayton.
Zips now 7 of 10 from outside the arc, 70% tonight here at Millett Hall. This is Sabandi, gives it off to Bowman. And you have to really give a shout-out to the defense of the Zips as Makai Larry misses there, and Williams gets the rebound. Ahead comes Jackson. Jovic on him defensively. Thought about stepping back for the 3. Instead, throws it left side. They go down low. Williams with Makai Larry on him on the baseline. got the ball back after had it knocked away, but he finds a man on the weak side. Tyler Cheese puts it off the glass and in, and it's a 17-point advantage for Akron.
Yeah, all the Miami eyes were on the ball in the corner, and nobody saw Cheese coming from the weak side wide open under the basket.
This is a 13-0 run by the Zips. They lead it 28-11. Jovic finds Leary, and they go down low to Bam Bowman. Three blue jerseys out there underneath the basket along with Bowman as they get it back out to Leary with nine to shoot. Out front, Bowman thought about a three, now steps to the left side. Deep three is off the mark, and Banks with the rebound.
Yeah, right now Miami's offense is stagnant. The people just standing around on the perimeter.
And the defense isn't much better, but there's a big block by Bam Bowman on the run. And now ahead it goes to Sabandi for the slam. Nike Sabandi makes his presence felt here tonight with his first 2 points, a monster dunk.
Yeah, he slowed up just enough to let Cheese fly by and then cranked it over his head.
And losing the handle on it was Christian Jackson, and this is Leary across the timeline to Bowman. Sabandi again working out front. Bam Bowman slips the screen, throws it too hard off the glass. Contact, but no call. And ahead come the Akron Zips. They lob it down low. Cheese against Coleman Land. Size mismatch. And Tyler Cheese now with seven.
Yeah, that time Cheese just used his body angle to get around Coleman Land and get the layup.
And nearly a steal. And that is off of Miami's Isaiah Coleman Land. It'll go to the Zips. Substitutions coming in. Ali is back into the game along with Cameron Reese.
Yeah, Miami's offense right now is just not clicking. They are yelling at each other. There's not good motion on offense except for that fast break from Sabandi. In the last 5 minutes or so, Miami just can't get anything going.
This is a 15-3 run right now by the Akron Zips as Jackson has it out top as we approach 8 minutes to go in the half. Working to the left side, keeping the dribble to the free throw line. Gives it up to Cheese. He'll fire a three from there. It's an air ball. Rebound, though, on the weak side. Missed, but it falls into the hands of Ali to the left corner. Firing and rattling in the three is Tyler Cheese. He's got 10.
Yeah, that time it looked like Miami played a little bit better defense. They forced a tough shot from the right side, but then Cheese got an open three from the left side and was able to hit it.
20-point advantage for the Akron Zips. Now 8 of 12 from outside the arc as Sabandi going to work. On the right side, keeps the dribble down the heart of the lane, lays it off the glass and in. Nice drive, got by his man, and puts it off the glass and in.
Yeah, Dawson had him out front. Nobody closed out on him. That allowed him to get to the basket and rose over the defense for the layup.
Jackson curls to the left elbow, keeps the dribble, and then has it stolen away by Jovic. Jovic looking to take it coast to coast. He'll lay it up. Travel is the call against Jovic. Trying to time it up and walked with the basketball. The turnover will give it back to Akron when we come back. 7:01 to play in the half. Akron is rolling, but Sabandi is slamming. Take a look at the Mid-American Conference news and notes here on this Tuesday evening. Players of the week, Cloudon from Bowling Green and Williams from Buffalo were named the Mid-American Conference Men's Players of the Week. And, of course, these Akron Zips suffered their first loss in conference play on Saturday. It was when Toledo handed them the loss. And Marion Jackson, 36 points, a career high, but it wasn't enough to get him the Player of the Week honors. And, of course, Friday night action coming up. One game on Friday night, nationally televised at 6:30. It's these Akron Zips in the Wagon Wheel game, first edition, against Kent State at the Jar.
Yeah, that one should be an epic battle. Both of these teams, we've seen them both now, and they're both very good.
Dawson misses the three in a battle for the rebound. Grabbed by Miami's Day-Day Grant, who's back in along with Myjay White. The starters out there for Miami, save for Bam Bowman as Precious Aya is on the floor at the big. This is Sabandi. He's going to drive, tries to feed to Delonte Brown. It goes off his fingertips out of bounds. It'll go to the Akron Zips as Xeyrius Williams is back in along with Channel Banks for the Zips.
Yeah, just a spacing issue that time between Sabandi and Brown. As Brown was cutting to the hole, probably would have been better to go to the corner and leave some space for Nike to get all the way to the rim.
Cheese brings it up the floor for the Akron Zips to Williams. Now back to Cheese. Illegal screen called on Cameron Reese. That moving screen is his second and the team's eighth.
Moved just a little bit early that time and kind of ran into the Miami player who was trying to cut across the screen.
Dang Riak comes into the game as Reese will head to the sidelines. Still not agreeing with the call. Miami will inbound it. Tribble is back into the game. He's playing with two fouls. Day-Day Grant off the right side gives it out front to Brown. Sabandi now working on Banks, back to Brown. He's going to fake, lost the handle on it, but Sabandi is there to pick it up. 15 to shoot. Really trying to get Brown involved in this offense. 10 to shoot. Sabandi against Williams will fire the three. It is off the mark, and the rebound by Channel Banks for the Akron Zips.
Yeah, another forced three by Miami. Not a good shot in rhythm.
Shot in rhythm there for Williams is partially touched, I believe, by Aya, and he gets a hustle on it but knocks the ball out of bounds on the rebound. It'll stay with Akron.
Yeah, that time Aya just kind of left Williams after the shot, and Williams was able to get inside position to try and run it down in the corner, and a good job by Aya just to knock it out of bounds.
Tyler Cheese will inbound the basketball, gets it into Banks in the right corner. Down low goes to Cheese, working on the smaller Myjay White. He'll put it on the floor, spin to the block, hooks around with that left hand, scores. Tyler Cheese now with 12 points in the ball game, and Akron's lead is at 20 once again.
Not much else that White could do. He kept his position, kept him between he and the basket, but just too strong.
Delonte Brown drives and draws the charge, does Channel Banks. No basket. The foul is on Delonte Brown. That is his second, team's fourth. And you see Tyler Cheese slipping over there to take the charge on the Miami junior out of Toledo, Ohio.
Yep, did a good job of staying outside the restricted area, had and was set so that all Brown could do was run him over.
This is Cheese across the timeline as we approach 5 minutes to go in the first half. It has been all Akron. Xeyrius Williams fakes the three, now goes to the basket off the glass. It is short as Precious Aya comes out and stays vertical. This is Sabandi taking it right to the basket, missing, and the rebound and a foul against Miami. I believe they'll get Precious Aya for this one. And indeed they do. The junior, redshirt junior out of Bales Estate, Nigeria, collects his first and the team's fifth. Lauren Christian Jackson back into the game along with Michael Dawson. Tribble and Cheese will head to the sidelines.
Yeah, Precious Aya that time crashing the board but just went over the top of an Akron Zip. Just the fifth team foul, though, for Miami, so Akron still two away from shooting free throws.
Zips with the basketball. Miami trying to find a way to get some offense here. They've managed 15 points in the first 15 minutes as Williams left elbow, 15-footers, a rainbow that's short, and the rebound tapped around into the hands of Day-Day Grant for the Redhawks. Day-Day Grant, crossover dribble, finds, tried to find Delonte Brown, but a great defensive play there by Chandler Banks to read the pass, step into the lane, and come up with a steal.
Yeah, he baited him the whole way, was off him. He thought Brown was open. By the time he fired it, there was Banks.
Jackson all the way to the glass will score. 10 in the game for Lauren Christian Jackson, and the lead is 22.
Yeah, once he got to the free throw line, nobody picked him up. Everyone let him go, and it was smooth sailing all the way to the rim.
Ajay White works out front to Aya. Back to Day-Day Grant. Five field goals in the game as Sabande gets to the rack, tries the dunk, and he'll get the foul on Tang Riak. That'll be his second, team's ninth, and Sabande will go to the free throw line and shoot two as he tried to throw that one down with both hands. The junior out of Indianapolis will be at the free throw line in just a moment as the Redhawks trying to find some offense, down by 22.
This event is an auction gala to support Miami University student-athlete scholarships and your time to wear your best red and white. Please register by March 18th.
I don't have anything here. Can we do a VO sometime soon? I have nothing to. /RW2020.
Minutes 50 seconds remaining here in the first half. It's been all Akron. Easy to see why. Their defense number one and their three-point shooting number two. Randy Holloway.
Yeah, as soon as Miami gets control of the basketball, they are in their jerseys, not giving the Redhawks any space on the offensive end for the Zips. As you mentioned it, they are shooting lights out from three-point range. 8 of 14 so far here in the half. They're shooting 52% overall from the field, but 57% from behind the arc, and that's what they do all year long.
Free throw by Sabandi is good. That'll make the current run by the Akron Zips 22-6 as Jaden Sales, a junior out of Cincinnati, Ohio, checks into the game, and Dang Riak will go to the bench. Second free throw by Sabandi is on the way, and it is good. He's got six.
Yeah, now just 8 points out of 14th place on the Miami all-time scoring list for Nike Sabandi.
Coming up on 3.5 minutes to play as Makai Larry tees up Warren Christian Jackson out front. Tyler Cheese along with Sales as Jackson blows by him and gets drilled by Precious Aya. Aya will pick up his second and the team sixth. And Warren Christian Jackson gets up off the floor and he'll go to the free throw line for two.
You saw there Miami trying to fight over the screen, and then Jackson went straight to the hole, and it looked like Aya thought he was going straight up, but he did lean into him.
Not shooting free throws here. I'm not sure I understand that one.
Guess he never got the shot off. So
Banks with the ball right side. Dribbles top of the key, gives it back to Lauren Christian Jackson. He'll drive again, and the shot is blocked by Makai Larry. It's out of bounds, and it will belong to the Miami Redhawks.
How about Larry's guy?
Not sure
the
if there wasn't any contact there, but well, if you're a Miami fan, you'll certainly take it.
Absolutely, as Larry got up and his first block of the season.
I was going to say.
On someone about equal size.
At 5'8", he's not going to get too many of them on the year. This is Larry. Gives it out top to Aya. Now Myjay White works to the elbow. Jovic puts it on the floor, finds White. He'll fire a three. It is an air ball, but underneath, Makai Larry gets a rebound and a stick back.
Yeah, he gets the block at one end and an offensive board and put back at the other.
Let me go play with the bigs.
He thinks he's 6'8 instead of 5'8 there. You see the air ball and Larry in the right place at the right time and forces the foul.
Lauren Christian Jackson gets the foul. That is his second, team's 10th. Larry will be at the free throw line for the and one here. Sophomore out of Evansville, Indiana. Lefty fires and gets. Miami now 7 of 8 from the free throw line.
Yeah, if there's anything negative for Akron in the first half, it's the foul trouble, right? Yeah. I mean, starting to mount a little bit. Over 10 fouls already, and some of their key players have two apiece.
Cheese running the point now with Jackson on the bench. Screen set to the left side. They get Xeyrius Williams out front. He's just going to take it to the right side of the key. Fire from 14. And rolls around and go down. Yeah. Xeyrius Williams with 11.
Yeah, high arc for that. Now three players in double digits already in the first half for Akron.
This is Larry carried the basketball. That hesitation got the hand underneath the basketball. And the turnover gives it back to the Akron Zips.
Yeah, another turnover for Miami as they're closing in on double digits in that category for the first half, and that cannot make head coach Jack Owens happy.
This is Cheese across the timeline, around a screen by Williams. Miami. To the corner it goes. Ali with the basketball, dribbles to the free throw line. 15 to shoot as Williams drives baseline. Gives it back to Ali and out front to Cheese with 10 to shoot. Screen set out front by Sales. He'll drive, lost the handle on it, and that'll be a foul called against Miami. Foul, I believe, is going to be on Precious Aya, and that will be his third and the team's seventh. And the Zips this time will go to the free throw line, shooting 1-1. It's Tyler Cheese.
Yeah, pretty good defense by Miami and kind of a bailout there as Aya came over late. Cheese was a little out of control, but the bump allowed him to lose the basketball there, and that's why they called the foul.
Free throws up and good. Cheese with 13 as Bam Bowman returns to the Red Hawk lineup. Cheese 80% from the line. He connects on them both. He's got 14 now. Averages 15 and a half points a game. Nearly has his average here in the first half with still 2 minutes to play. This has been Akron's night thus far as Sabandi on the right side drives past Channel Banks. Tries to throw it cross court to Larry in the corner. It's knocked out of bounds by Akron. Miami keeps it with 14 to shoot.
Yeah, that time good closeout by Akron. They were not going to allow Nike to get to the rim. His only thought at that point then was to find Larry in the corner.
Jovich throws the ball away, trying to find White, and that was Ali that stepped in front. Xeyrius Williams left side with it, gets it back out front, and the Zips look to use a little bit of clock here with a minute 40 to play in the half. Cheese feeds out top. Williams open three. It is too strong, and the rebound tapped right into the hands of Bam Bowman for Miami. Ahead to Jovich. Jovich to Bowman. Fakes the three, feeds out top. The length of Akron changes so many shots right now for Miami as Larry gets to the basket again with a right hand over top of Xeyrius Williams. He's got 5 in a row for the Redhawks.
Yeah, he went over the 6'9 Williams and the 6'9 Jaden Sales to get that one to go. He's playing well above his height so far here in the first half.
Coming up on 60 seconds to play here in the half as Cheese behind the back at the free throw line. Bounces it down low. Sales puts the body on Bam Bowman on a reach-in foul called against Miami. They'll get Nike Sabandi for that one. It'll be his first, team's eighth. And Jaden Sales will go to the free throw line and shoot. 6'9", 235-pound junior out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Puts it up and in.
Yeah, Sales the junior out of Sycamore High School. A couple of Cincinnati players on this roster.
John Gross has done a nice job with this program in his third year. Second one is up and good. Zips remain perfect from the line. 5 of 5, 30-second timeout taken here by the Zips as they extend the lead to 21. Led by as many as 22, and I'm not sure if You take a look at John Gross here. He's got to be pretty happy. But on the other end, I'm not sure that Jack Owens has too many solutions down there right now.
Yeah, for Miami, it's going to come down to they're going to have to start making some shots and playing a little bit better defense, forcing tougher shots from Akron. Akron comes in averaging about 73 points a game, well above that average right now at 43 in the first half. And, yeah, Miami's got to find some kind of an answer to what the Zips are throwing out there, because right now everything is working for Akron.
It is indeed, and you see the Miami huddle there trying to find some solutions. And, again, the Redhawks have not been for Makai Larry over the last 3 minutes. They would still be sitting about 5 points ago, because Larry, with a couple of shots underneath the basket, not a bad thing for a guy 5'8", and a free throw is trying to keep Miami in this game. Here's that 1-2-2 press at the half. Now they switch to a 2-3 zone to the Zips. Sabandy off the left side, lots of length out front. Makai Larry back to Sabandy, 13 to shoot. Bowman sets the screen to the right side, Larry. Larry will put it on the floor, pull up from the free throw line and knock it down. That is 7 straight points for the Redhawks from Makai Larry. Back to a 19-point ball game.
And that's what you want to do against the zone, get the ball to the middle. If you can't do it with the pass to the high post, you dribble drive, and then you can dish, or in that case, the little short jumper.
Tyler Cheese out front, shot clock and the game clock just about the same. Cheese out front, Myjai White waiting for the move. He's got screen set either side, and he'll use the Xeyrius Williams screen to the left side with 6 to shoot. Tyler Cheese launches at the buzzer. It's no good. 1 second to go, and Sabandy, three-quarter court. The shot is up, and it's no good, and we've reached the half. Here at Millett Hall, the Akron Zips have been ruling the evening. They lead by 19 at the break at 43-24. As an outstanding job by the Akron Zips defensively and shooting the threes have gotten them a big lead. Let's check in with Bennett Wise, who's with the Zips head coach, John Gross.
Coach, you guys have dominated this first half. What has worked so well for you?
Well, we've defended, you know. We got to do it for 20 more minutes. We didn't defend very well the other day or up to our capabilities, so our guys were really motivated, obviously, on that end of the floor.
And you got 4 guys with 2 fouls. What can you do to minimize those in the second half?
Well, we just got to do exactly that, right? We got to manage it the best we can. And, you know, we take pride in defending without fouling. We got to do a better job of that.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Zips up 43-24 here at the break. You see the stats, 48% shooting from the field, 50% from the three-point range. Big difference in the ball game as the Zips lead it by 19 at the break. Steve Baker, Randy Hollowell, and Bennett Wise back with you here at Millett Hall in Oxford, ready to begin things in the second half. And those Akron Zips are out in front by 19 at 43-24. Drastically different moods, I think, in the locker rooms here at the break.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're Akron, you just stay the course, right? I mean, everything that they did offensively and for the most part defensively worked. The only thing that they had issue with, I guess, is the foul trouble a little bit. And you heard John Gross talk about it at halftime for Miami. They got to start to get things going early, and you hope that they can do it. And they're gonna make a change in the lineup, and they're gonna start Mekhi Larry, who was hot there late in that half.
Mekhi Larry and Precious Ayah as Delonte Brown on the bench, along with Myjai White to begin this second half. Out top, Sabandi crosses over, finds Bowman, gets the ball back around a screen, finds Precious Ayah going to the basket for two.
Good job, a good feed that time by Sabandi, and then it was Precious Ayah using the rim to protect that shot.
Tyler Cheese out front with a basketball, dribbles to the left side, leaves it for Lauren Christian Jackson, a little bump, no call. Out top, Xeyrius Williams for three. That one's too hard, and Sabandi with the rebound for Miami. Redhawks run the other way. Mekhi Larry all the way to the basket with the left hand is too strong. And the rebound to Williams for Akron. Ahead it goes to Jackson. Jackson will run the other way. Gets bumped all the way down the floor and no call. That ball is out of bounds and it will stay with Akron as Lauren Christian Jackson just looks up at Frank Spencer and says, what, no call?
I think they're almost going to say incidental contact, although even though he turned his back to him, you can see a little bit of bumping going on from Larry, but I guess they just decide to no foul, no call. But
ball went out of bounds off of Lauren Christian Jackson in Miami with the basketball. Larry with the big man Williams on him now, so a mismatch down low. Thought about pulling the trigger and couldn't do it. Sabandi out top. He'll work against React. Gets a little push on him to the free throw line. It's an air ball thrown up there. Off balance shot by Sabandi, and here come the Zips. Action's moving along a little quicker here in this second half as Banks steps into another one.
Yeah, there might have even been contact by Grant, but the shot falls, and just like that, again, Akron takes off where they left off, shooting the three and making the three.
Back out to the 20-point advantage. They've led by as many as 22. This is Day-Day Grant behind the back, feeding to the right side. Bam Bowman thought about a three, now fires from 18. It is off the mark. Rebound tapped up. Precious Ayah. No, they're going to say that the Zips were last to touch it. Now they'll get a correction.
Yep.
It is off of Miami's Precious Ayah, and it will go to Akron.
Yeah, you see the official on the far side come over and correct it. And I think that's the right
call.
That's
a good call, yeah.
Precious did knock it towards this side of the court.
2 minutes gone by here in the second half, still a 20-point advantage. They led by 19 to the Akron Zips at the break. Lauren Christian Jackson around the screen, keeps that dribble all the way to the basket, feeds to the corner. Xeyrius Williams will tee up another three, and this one is good.
And there you see the experience of Williams. He checked his feet to make sure they were both behind the line before he fired.
Largest lead of the game as Miami throws the ball away, but now there'll be a traveling violation called against Mekhi Larry.
Larry that time just got out of control down and nowhere to go with the basketball. He had three big guys right around him and ended up traveling before he threw it away.
Larry was 7 first half points and trying to expand upon that, but got caught in no man's land. Jackson works the right side of the floor, keeps the dribble to the basket. Shot rejected by Precious Ayah into the hands of Day-Day Grant. Day-Day will pull up left side. Three is good for Day-Day Grant. Freshman out of Lorain, Ohio, has his 12th point.
Yeah, he was hot early, then didn't score again for the last maybe 15 minutes of the first half, but comes out firing and hits his first three.
This is Tyler Cheese, right side with the basketball. Works around the screen, gets Bowman on him, fires from 17, and the lefty knocks it down. Tyler Cheese. He's got 16 points to lead all scorers.
Talked about Akron 15 times. They've had a 20-point score on the way again this game.
Sabandi misses, battling the rebound. Day-Day Grant has it knocked away. And Paul Cheese goes down hard along with Day-Day Grant. And Tyler Cheese a little shaken up on the play. He's going to walk it off as Isaiah Coleman-Lands comes into the game for Miami. Cameron Reese along with Greg Tribble into the game for the Zips. Reak and Cheese will go to the bench. And for Miami, Makai Leary heads to the sidelines with Coleman Lands into the game. And Delonte Brown up off the Miami bench. He's going to come get Bam Bowman.
That's the second time we've seen players slide and slip in that corner.
Yeah.
Jackson did it earlier in the first half.
15 to shoot here for Miami. This is Sabandi firing the deep three. It's too actually well off target. Sabandi having trouble finding the range from distance tonight, as are the rest of the Red Hawks, and it'll belong to the Zips.
Yeah, 6 points in the first half for Sabandi, and has yet to find the range here in the second 20.
Miami now 2 of 10 from three-point range at 20%. The Zips are at 53%. Banks from the right corner, hits another one. Channel Banks, he's got 12 in the game on four trays, and it's a 25-point advantage.
Right now, they just can't miss from the outside, and it doesn't matter if Miami's getting in their face or not, they are triggering them.
Day-Day Grant, he'll go to the line as he's fouled, and Lauren Christian Jackson has picked up his third foul in the team's first of the second half. The Akron Zips have a 25-point advantage due to this one. Channel Banks from the right corner for the triple, giving the Zips the big lead. Other action around the Mid-American Conference. All these at the half. Eastern Michigan and the road at Bowling Green tied at 27. Northern Illinois leading Kent State by 8 at the half. In Kent is a surprise. Western Michigan and Buffalo tied up, and Toledo leading on the road against the Bobcats. Here it has been all Akron from just about the opening tip. They took a 7-point advantage early, and they just keep rolling on it here. Up by 25, Randy Hollowell.
Yeah, they averaged just under 10 made three-pointers a game. They've already made 11 here, and we still got 16 minutes to go in the ball game. They shooting about 55% from the land of Trey so far today.
Day-Day Grant at the free throw line for Miami. The freshman from Lorain, Ohio, gets the first one. He's got 13 points, for the Redhawks.
Yeah, seventh straight game. He's been in double figures, scoring an 11th overall for the freshman from Lorain.
3 of 4 from the line, and has another one coming up here. And that one rims out on him as Cheese grabs the rebound and lobs it ahead to Tribble. He'll give it off to Williams. Williams thought about pulling the trigger again and thought better of it. Give it off to Reese on the right side. Hands it off to Cheese. Dangerous as he drives to the basket. Feeds to the corner to Banks. Banks will put it on the floor with 10 to shoot. Gives it out top to Tribble. Tribble lobs it down low. Williams against Coleman Lands. Mismatch and no chance at all for Coleman Lands. Xeyrius Williams. Xeyrius Williams, that is, with 16.
Yeah, Miami got caught in a switch, and they had the guard on the big man. He took him right to the hole.
Lante Brown gives it off to Coleman Lands with 18 to shoot. 26-point advantage as Day-Day Grant straight away looking at a triple, knocks it down for his 16th.
Yep, that's what he will do. He can definitely score, and he can shoot the three-pointer. And he is red hot now, one of the few Red Hawks that has found the range here this evening.
Just under 15 minutes to go as Cheese works against Majay White. Gets a screen to the right side, finds Williams out front. Now it goes to Tribble with 14 to shoot. He's going to blow by Day-Day Grant, and that's an offensive foul. Tribble lowered that shoulder and collects his third foul, team second.
There, you saw him just there. He got his elbow just kind of a little bit away from the body and into the chest of Day-Day Grant. That's the second time that Day-Day Grant has taken one of those kinds of charges here this afternoon or evening.
Both against Tribble. 14 and a half minutes to go here as Grant has it out top. Whistle and an offensive foul away from the ball. The illegal screen set down low by, I believe, a check head is going on to Lonte Brown. I thought maybe they were going to get Precious Aya, but it's Brown, and that is his third and the team's first.
It was Brown trying to open things up there for Coleman Land. You see, that was a ticky-tack thing right there, but the foul on Brown down just inside the block.
Double-checking that, the official scorer has that as his fourth. Cheese across the timeline, gives to Williams, working on Milos Jovic, who came in for Delonte Brown. To Banks, curling to the elbow, 14-footer is too strong, and Jovic has the rebound for the Redhawks. Gets it ahead to Day-Day Grant down the left side. Grant. Little slip of the screen by Aya, had it knocked away by Tyler Cheese. Lots of contact in this game. They are letting them play for the most part. The lob to Tribble is too strong, but a foul called against Miami, and Tribble will go to the free throw line and shoot two. I believe they'll get Grant for this one.
Yeah, a little bit of bump there going kind of for the alley-oop there from behind. Just a little touch by Grant, but it doesn't take much when somebody's up in the air like that to throw them off balance and can be a very dangerous play.
Tribble at the free throw line, a 48% free throw shooter. Doesn't look like it at all there. Eli McNamara into the game for Miami, replacing Precious Aya. Ali is into the game. And Williams will go out.
Yeah, one of the things with this big lead, that what it affords Akron is the ability to rotate players constantly here through the second half.
Reese is also into the game as Chandler Banks headed to the sidelines. Back to a 25-point advantage, largest lead of the game for the Akron Zips, as we're under 14 minutes to go in this one. The Hawks just have not been able to put together a consistent scoring series here as Jovic pulls up. 8-footer is too strong, and it's been that kind of night for Miami. You get close, get an open look, and you just can't knock it down.
Yeah, and actually good offensive play that time for Miami to get an open look, as you said, from about 8 feet, but Jovic a little bit strong as he kind of short-armed it.
Lauren Christian Jackson on the dribble out front is going to hand it to Tyler Cheese. Back to Jackson, left open, fires the three, gets the three. First time in a while, but 13 in the game for Lauren Christian Jackson.
Yeah, right in front of his bench, and found the range. Miami, again, very slow rotating to get a hand in his face.
28-point lead is the largest of the game for the Zips. Under 13 to play. Jovic straight away. Three-pointer is up and good for Milos Jovic, his first points of the ball game.
Yeah, that time it was Cheese who was a little late getting the hand up in his face, and Jovic can hit that. Doesn't shoot it a lot, but he is very potent from the three-point line if you give him the opportunity.
This is Cheese out front, 14 to shoot for the Zips. Majay White on him defensively, gets a screen to the right side. Cheese to the basket, gets double teamed, finds Ali out front, 4 to shoot. Ali will drive and put it up and get the roll at the buzzer. Ali. Freshman out of Kendallville, Indiana, puts it up and in.
Showed a little bit of strength, able to pull away from Coleman Lance, who got a reach in on the ball, and then was able to force it up over Majay White and got the roll.
Grant driving, feeding underneath to Eli McNamara, who puts it off the glass with the left hand and scores.
Good control by Grant underneath, found the open guy. I thought he may have dribbled too far underneath the basket, but McNamara bailed him out that time.
Under 12 to play in the basketball game. Up in that media timeout area. Christian Jackson gives it to Reese, and that'll be a charge called on Cameron Reese. That'll be his third, and the team's third as well. The under 12 timeout sees the Akron Zips continuing to lead big over the Miami Redhawks.
Yeah, we're going to do that. So, Wayne, you're going to want shots of Isaiah Coleman-Land for us, and then your their head coach, John Gross. Four for us and their head coach. I don't care.
Smarter is the smarter way to buy tickets to live.
Sounds
events.
Good to me.
If you're looking to experience and enjoy the power and excitement of all the best sports, concerts, and theater events, visit ticketsmarter.com and download the app today. Don't miss out. Smart fans start at ticketsmarter.com.
You go back.
Unfortunately, be sure to stop at the Left Field Tavern at Oak Club after tonight's game, located on Park Place just off of High Street.
How much time?
Left Field Tavern and Oak Club. Proud partners of Miami Athletics. Miami University Athletics would like to thank Adidas as the official supplier and outfitter for the Miami Redhawks.
Well, this isn't the first time Akron Zips head coach John Gross has come across a Coleman Lance. Isaiah's brother Jalen played 2 years at Illinois under Gross before transferring to DePaul, and he said that they have very similar styles of play. They both like to shoot the three, both play with a lot of passion. He said really the only difference, he said while laughing too, is that Jalen has a 4-inch height advantage over Isaiah.
No doubt about that, but some talent in that family for the Coleman Lance family. And for Miami, I know that Jack Owens is hoping Coleman Lance can light it up here over the last 11:38.
Yeah, coming into play today, he led the team and made three-pointers. And when he's hot, he can be very hot. And he hits key three-pointers sometimes, too.
Deng Riak and Xeyrius Williams. Xeyrius Williams back into the game for the Zips, as this is Makai Larry, who's back in for Miami. Coleman Lance gets it down low to McNamara. He's going to back his way in on Riak. Going to turn in the paint. The jump hook is short. Contact but no call. The ball out to Williams.
Yeah, that time McNamara just not strong enough. Got defense too much up in him, and he couldn't get enough on the shot.
This is Williams lobbing it down low to Riak, who puts it off the glass and in. Easy hoop there for Deng Riak. His first 2 points of the ball game, 65-38, 27-point lead.
One big guy to the other on the nice look, and easy two for Akron.
High low after the screen set out top. The shot. They say the foul happened before the shot, and it is on Xeyrius Williams, his first, team's fourth, and Miami will have the basketball out of bounds as Jack Owens questioning Brooks Wells as to why that wasn't a made basket.
Yeah, I think they caught that first forearm, that's what they said, before he was into his shooting motion.
And McNamara is left alone. He got by Channel Banks and lays it up and in, and Channel Banks raises his hand and said, yeah, that was me.
One of the few times that Akron has made a defensive error, and that time they just left the basketball, and McNamara says thank you very much as he drives the baseline.
Jackson works left side. Williams out front trying to get it down low. They do to Riak. His jump hook is too strong. Rebound, though, grabbed by Dawson, and he is on the baseline out of bounds. It'll belong to Miami.
Yeah, Riak that time doesn't score a lot, but he coming off the layup the last time down, thought he could get another one, and that little kind of hook shot on the baseline just wouldn't go down for him. And he got the offensive rebound, but then stepped out of bounds.
Larry finds Jovic on the right side. He'll put it on the floor. 10 minutes to go in this one from Millett Hall as Jovic drives, feeds underneath to McNamara for the two-handed slam. Nice move from Jovic to find McNamara underneath the basket. The lead is 23.
And good job by McNamara to make himself available on that left block and to be able to be open for Jovic.
React comes up and sets the screen. Works to the left side as Jackson gets it in the corner to Dawson. Williams out front with 10 to shoot. Back to Jackson it goes. Miami switches, and Jackson fires and scores. Not much you can do about that when Lauren Christian Jackson's feeling it like that. 16 in the game for him.
Yeah, Jackson now from three-point range, 4 for 4.
This is Larry pulling up from 18. It's too strong, and Jackson with the rebound. Pace of this game has settled down quite a bit here as Zips content with using a little bit of clock, but there, Lauren Christian Jackson, a heat check of about 25, 30 feet, said maybe I shouldn't have taken that one.
Yeah, he was 4 for 4, as we mentioned, from behind the arc going into that one. That one probably a little ill-advised, and he's going to go sit on the bench for a minute.
Trittle into the game, replacing Jackson, and Dawson will leave as Tyler Cheese is back into the game for the Zips. 9:01 to play, and a 26-point advantage for the Akron Zips.
And again, with Akron with the big lead, it allows them to rest some guys a little bit. They stay on the road after this one on Saturday. They head down to Athens to take on the Bobcats.
Larry gets it out top to McNamara, now to Coleman Lands. To Jovic, 15 to shoot as Sabandi gets the basketball. Back to Jovic, thought about a three, now fakes, drives, and will get fouled. Xeyrius Williams is guilty of the personal. That is his second, team's fifth. And Milos Jovic will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, good fake that time by Jovic. Fake the pass, then as he drove, changed hands twice to go to his right hand, just to leaves it a little bit short.
Just got him down low with that right hand. Not much contact there. We've seen a lot worse than has gone on with no call. Jovic puts it up and in. 53% free throw shooter.
Just ask Lauren Christian Jackson about that.
Exactly. 8:40 to go. Second free throw by Jovic on the way for the Redhawks, and it is good. Well, it's trying to cut into it, but about every time they start to do that, somebody steps up and hits a big three for the Akron Zips. This is Cheese with the basketball on the left side. Out front, there is Xeyrius Williams, and that's exactly what I'm talking about. 19 in the game for Xeyrius Williams.
Yeah, you think you have the pick and roll defended, and maybe you do, but then someone steps out on the other side to hit the three. That time it was Williams.
Out front, this is McNamara for three, and the bank is open for Eli McNamara.
Just kind of interesting reaction by McNamara as he was going back on defense. Just that kind of, yep,
meant
it happened.
I called it. Channel Banks on the right side nearly had it stolen away by Jovic. Now they lob it underneath to React on the block. He's going to go to work on McNamara. Turn shot is blocked, but they got him with the body, and Jack Owen says nope. There's a foul. Eli McNamara second, team's third. Timeout on the floor. 7:47 to go in this one, and the Akron Zips up by 24. 7:47 to go in this one. You mentioned it, Randy. The Zips on the road for their next one. On the 25th, they'll travel to Ohio before heading back to take on the Buffalo Bulls. Then that wagon wheel game on the 31st against Kent State. And the Eastern Michigan will be their next opponent there at the Jar. For the Miami Redhawks, they have a couple more at home, but challenges to say the least. Eastern Michigan at the bottom of the West Division should be a great game here on Saturday. Then Central Michigan at Northern Illinois to begin February, and then Western Michigan. So not bad for Jack Owens. He's got 3 out of 4 at home.
Yeah, you'd like to really 4 out of 5 when you count today, yeah. But not getting off to the start that he wanted here in the friendly confines.
Yeah, he's going to be 1 in 5, and looking at Eastern Michigan coming in, there is Dan Riak, graduate student from Melbourne, Australia, 6'10", 220, puts it up and misses, a 69% free throw shooter.
Another one of those transfers. He originally started his career at East Carolina.
Misses them both, and Sabandy with the rebound for Miami. Full court pressure here as they try to trap here at the half court, excuse me. And there is McNamara again for a two-handed flush as a no-look pass from Makai Larry.
Yeah, great look by Larry. And again, McNamara doing a good job on the block, getting open against that zone. And that's what you do. You move the ball around. You get a little dribble penetration. That draws the defense, and someone's going to be open.
Tyler Cheese, top of the key with the basketball against Sabandy. Backing it out with about 7 minutes to go. Gets a screen. Keeps that dribble, steps back, 18-footer, right side is no good. McNamara with the rebound, ahead to Sabandy. Sabandy. Coleman lands straight away with a triple, his first. And that gets Miami back into it. At least it gets it down to single digits as it's 71-52, or double digits, 19. It's at least it's under 20. We'll come back with more here in just one moment. Stay with us.
Hello, can you hear me? Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Do you want me to talk over the melt?
Yes.
I can talk over the melt if you want to.
Gotcha. So you're gonna start on camera.
Gotcha, okay. Elijah McNamara starting to come alive for Miami. He has 11 points in this ballgame. 5 for 7 from the field right now. Coach is very happy overall throughout the season with the progression of McNamara. They say he just needed to get over his confidence hump, start feeling more comfortable and less tense on the block. It's also good, too. They say he's starting to grow into his body a little bit more, which is very good news for the Redhawks, providing some more depth for Delonte Brown and Bam Bowman.
Definitely need some help at the bigs, and tonight it is Elijah McNamara providing that help. Full court pressure here by Miami as we're under 7 minutes to go, and it's a 19-point ball game. Zips has led by as many as 28. Lauren Christian Jackson back out there with 3 fouls. He gets it across the timeline to Cheese and then gets the ball back. Coleman Lance comes out to pick him up defensively.
Gives
15
Miami
to shoot.
To work on some things now.
Yeah. Jackson crossover dribble and a beauty as he gets to the basket. Now dribbles through with 5 to shoot. And a foul away from the ball will go against Isaiah Coleman Lance, his first and the team's 4th.
That's his first. Team's 4th.
Yeah, I think he was holding Reese down low. It's again a mismatch on a switch.
Whistle and a foul again will go against Coleman Lands on a hold. That is his second and the team's fifth.
Yeah, I think they inadvertently say it was going to be a one and one, but really it should be underneath.
It's only the team's fifth foul. Miami's still got a couple to give. Get it into Banks in the corner. Christian Jackson all the way to the paint, feeds to the right side to Channel Banks, seven to shoot. He's going to lob it out there as Makai Larry putting the defense on. Pull up 18-footer is off the glass and in for Lauren Christian Jackson. He's got 18 points in the ball game. When it's going right, it's going right.
Yeah, right at his average on the season, and you see why. He can create on his own, probably as good as anybody in this conference right now.
Right side, Coleman Lands to Sabandi. Thought about a three, now finds Coleman Lands available for a three, and he hits it. Six in a game for Coleman Lands, 18-point advantage. Timeout taken. Going to keep it right here at 5:49 to play.
Yeah, good job by Miami moving it around. They had a couple opportunities to shoot, waited for a better shot, and finally was Coleman Lands, who we have seen make huge three-pointers all season long, and here's another one.
Nice, pure shot. Got it straight away and off the right side and nails it for his second tray and has 6 points in the ballgame as Miami, again, continuing to try and mount the comeback with 5:49 to go. Day-Day Grant checked into the Miami lineup during that timeout as you see Jack Owens talking to his troops. Our next broadcast coming up on Saturday as Miami will entertain the Eagles of Eastern Michigan University. Randy and I will have that for you along with Bennett Wise at 2 o'clock on Saturday.
You know, Bennett Wise was talking a little bit about the progression of Elijah McNamara. This is the third time he's been in double digits on the year. Had a career-high 14 against Wilberforce earlier this season.
This 11 may give him more confidence than that Wilberforce will.
Absolutely.
Against a very good basketball team here in the Zips. Full court pressure broken by the Zips as we approach 5.5 minutes to go. There's 17 to shoot for Akron. And Lauren Christian Jackson, if you're John Gross, is the guy you want handling the basketball. Milos Jovic trying to stay with him, and that's not going to work as he gives a head fake. He'll go up and under, miss the shot, but put back up and in by Tyler Cheese following the shot. Cheese now with 18 points in the game.
And that time, McNamara took himself out of rebounding position. He went for the late block and then had to lay off it. Otherwise, it would have been goaltending, and by then took himself out of position to get the rebound.
Milos Jovic out top with the basketball. Gets a screen. Keeps the dribble, and that'll be a hold called on Reese. They got Cameron Reese for the foul. Could have really went either way because Jovic was grabbing as well, but Reese had him by the arm, as you see here.
Got in
on the body.
Yeah, almost grabbed his jersey a little bit.
Dang React back into the game as Reese will head to the sideline. Team sixth foul as Reese picked up his fourth. Under the five-minute mark here. Day-Day Grant finds Coleman Lands driving down the lane, gets it baseline, and that shot is blocked. McNamara shot blocked by Reak and into the hands of Cheese, and here come the Zips with 4:40 to go.
Yeah, that time he took a little bit too long to get that shot off, did McNamara. That gave Reak time to get to the shot.
Channel Banks comes and gets the basketball and gives it back to Christian Jackson. Finding Williams in the corner, eight to shoot. He'll put it on the floor against Day-Day Grant. Gets in the paint, four to shoot. Christian Jackson drives, and that'll be a hold against Jovic with one on the shot clock. That will drive a coach insane. Precious Aya is into the game, replacing McNamara. Quality, quality minutes there for the sophomore out of Pickerington, Ohio.
Yeah, he's still, as we mentioned, still growing, still learning, but good spell there in the second half.
This is Tyler Cheese out front with it. And the ball knocked away by Precious Aya, who just checked into the contest. Gives it to Coleman Lands. Precious Aya is one of those guys for Jack Owens that doesn't score a lot, but every time he's on the floor for the Miami Redhawks, he's just 150%.
Yeah, an energy guy for sure. Rebounding, blocking some shots, also will set some nasty screens.
Jovich gives it off to Coleman, lands, misses the shot, got his own rebound. Two to shoot, he catches iron that time, but the rebound is out to Williams as he misses two in a row.
Yeah, Miami just not able to buy one right there. They got some positioning on a great pass, but no conversion from Coleman Lands.
Banks out front, under 3.5 minutes to go. Jackson now with the basketball. 9 to shoot as they get it to Xeyrius Williams. He's going to turn from 18, miss it, and the rebound to Sabandi for Miami. Sabandi working on Tyler Cheese, crossover dribble, getting into the paint, needing some help, and throws the ball away. Tried to get it out to Day-Day Grant, but throws it into the scorer's table instead. 3:03 to go in this one, a 20-point advantage. It's been Akron from the opening tip as Cheese with the follow and the hoop. He's got 18 for Akron. Vince College Basketball on ESPN is brought to you by Skyline Chili. Feeling good, it's Skyline time. Steve Baker, Randy Hollowell, Bennett Wise back with you, the president of Miami University, making his presence here tonight as he usually is. He is always at the games here as the Red Hawks, unfortunately, have been taken to the woodshed tonight by the Akron Zips from the very get-go. Three-point shooting and their defense. I mean, if they play defense like this throughout the rest of the season, they will be MAC champs.
Yeah, it'll be tough to beat them for sure, especially they can shoot just a little bit, even close to what they're
shooting today. They gave up a big performance in the loss, but their lone loss on Saturday as they get it down low to Williams. He misses, but Sales is there to follow it up for the Zips. He's got 4 in the game. But their defense will carry, as they say, defense travels. And it certainly traveled here tonight for the Akron Zips as Makai Larry out front to Precious Aya. He'll tee it up. It's off the mark. Rebound to Lante Brown underneath the basket. He's going to put it up. No, but he's getting fouled. And if that is triple, that'll be his 4th. Lante Brown will go to the free throw line as Greg Tribble picks up his 4th foul, team 7th.
Good job by Brown to go after that offensive rebound and force it back up. Good hustle. You talked about defense traveling. Defense and rebounding are the things, you know, those hustle stats. And they are out-rebounding Miami by 9. And the other big statistic, 7 more assists than the Red Hawks.
Brown misses the 1st of 2.
Yeah, Brown just 2 points. And actually, Brown and Sabandi have combined for just 8 points here.
Yeah. It's been Day-Day Grant as Brown makes the 2nd. Day-Day Grant, Elijah McNamara, and Makai Larry doing most of the job scoring here tonight.
Yeah, we talked about what McNamara's done. How about Day-Day Grant, a career high, although just a freshman, but a career high 16 points to this point.
He's been the most consistent Red Hawk, although he scored 9 early, then went away as Tribble drives and scores.
Miami that time in the press, but nobody picked up the basketball.
Makai Larry for 3. It's in and out, and Sales with the rebound for the Zips as under 2 minutes to go, and Jackson will slowly bring the ball up the floor.
Yeah, a little surprised he's still in there. Thought maybe he'd get a little bit more rest here as the game wore down.
Sales sets the screen, doesn't use it. Instead, Lauren Christian Jackson just blows by and scores again. 20 in the game for him.
Yeah, they talked about that this is the 16th time they've had a player with at least 20 points on the season.
Mayday Grant drives, feeds Precious Aya. He'll use that basket as an extra hand under there to make sure it doesn't get blocked. Protects the basketball with the basket. Scores his 4th point.
Yeah, look for Akron maybe to run the clock here a little bit.
Christian Jackson needs some help and gets it out to Banks with 10 to shoot. 64 seconds to play. Tribble, right side, is going to step back. The 19-footer is off the mark. Rebound out to Makai Larry. Doesn't have the numbers. He's going to drive baseline. Pull up 17-footer is good for Larry. He's got 9, and a timeout taken by Miami here to get subs into the game. Actually, Akron takes the timeout as Marquell McIntyre comes into the game along with Michael Dawson and Ali. Williams, Banks, and Jackson all head to the bench. And they'll hit their 15th win of the season as Jovich is into the game for Miami, replacing Delonte Brown. 19 points in the game for Xeyrius Williams, 12 for Channel Banks, 18 for Tyler Cheese, and 20 in the game for Lauren Christian Jackson.
Also coming in a late sub, Enrique Freeman, also now in for Akron.
Redshirt freshman out of Cleveland, Ohio. 6'7", 205-pounder. This is Tribble out front with a basketball. Zips will improve to 15-4, 5-1 in conference play. They'll continue to lead the East. As Tribble dribbling left side with 10 to shoot. Whistle and a foul will go against Makai Larry. That'll be his first, team 7th, and Tribble will go to the free throw line and shoot 1-1.
Yeah, trying to force himself through that screen that time. And just got a little bit too handsy, I guess, against the screener.
Misses the front end, but got his own rebound as Miami didn't box out. And 10 seconds between the game clock and the shot clock. And this is McIntyre, gives it up to Freeman. And now Dawson gets into the paint, spins to the baseline, tries to find Freeman. He wasn't looking for the pass. Jovich ahead to Makai Larry. He's going to get fouled by Freeman as he takes it to the basket. Enrique Freeman commits the foul. That is his first, team's 8th. And it'll be Makai Larry to the free throw line for Miami with 9.4 seconds to go as into the game comes Michael Ritchie for Isaiah Coleman-Lands and Benjamin Litikin comes in for Myjai White. So all the walk-ons are on for both teams for the final 9.4 seconds.
Yeah, when Larry puts on the Jets, there's not many players faster with the basketball in this league.
And that'll do it as they'll just dribble it out here as the Akron Zips come into Oxford and get their 15th win of the season. They improve to 15-4, 5-1 in Mid-American Conference play. Miami will drop to 8-11, 1-5 in Mid-American Conference play. And a big win on the road here for John Gross's Akron Zips as the Miami Redhawks have to be scratching their head in this one with just an outstanding night shooting and defense played by Akron here tonight.
Yeah, it was close to a perfect game. I mean, they had some foul trouble in the first half and a few breakdowns defensively in the second half, but overall a near perfect performance by the Zips. And something their coach was looking for was that defensive intensity, and he definitely got it this evening.
He did indeed, and John Gross is with our Bennett Wise on the sidelines. Bennett?
So you said before the game you wanted to get back to your game plan of speed in the pick and roll. How did you guys do that, and what does it say about your guys to be able to come back after the loss?
Well, I think what stood out was our defense. You know, we weren't very happy with the way we guarded on Saturday. And we had to get back to doing what we do and just do it better. So I thought, you know, our defense really gave us a chance to get out in transition and then gave us a little momentum that way. And then obviously I thought our pick and roll game was good today. And, you know, it's good when you've got, obviously you've got good players out there and we've got some guys that can play.
And you had four guys in double digits, you know, Cheese, Williams, and Christian Jackson. What does it say to have consistent scores like that?
Well, it's a lot of versatility. You know, we can score.